One of the advantages of having an analog system that is linear time invariant, or LTI, is that you can calculate the output using a convolution integral. But the integral can be hard to solve, and it doesn't give much intuition for understanding the system. To address these shortcomings, we often convert continuous time signals and systems into the Laplace domain. In this video, I'm presenting the Laplace transform and inverse Laplace transform for converting between the time and Laplace domains. I'll also go over a simple example. We're going to start by assuming that you have a causal function of time t. This means that it isn't defined before time zero. With this assumption, we can use the unilateral Laplace transform to convert the time domain function to the Laplace domain. The transform uses an integral over time to convert small f of t into big f of s. The integral includes the term e to the power of minus s times t. S is a complex variable that has both a real and imaginary component, and that will be very important when we start looking at the behavior of LTI systems in future videos. You can write the time domain and Laplace domain, or S domain, forms of a function next to each other, separated by a bidirectional arrow. This means that we can convert in either direction. The inverse Laplace transform uses an integral over S to convert big f of s back into small f of t. There's also an exponent here, but now it's to the power of positive s times t. There's also a shorthand for you to refer to the Laplace and inverse Laplace transforms, using a cursive L and an inverse cursive L. Now, I said earlier that we convert to the Laplace domain to avoid the convolution integral, but we still have an integral, or two integrals if you count the inverse transform. It turns out that these integrals are generally easier to solve than the convolution integral. Here's an example. Let's say you want to transform a step function where the signal jumps from 0 to 1 at time 0, then stays at 1 for all time. Over the range of the integral, the function is always 1, so you only have to integrate the exponential, which here means you just have to divide by the coefficient in the exponent, or minus s. Now you just apply the limits on time t. When time goes to infinity, this exponent shrinks and goes to 0, so you're left with substituting time equal to 0. The final result is 1 over s, which is defined everywhere except when s is equal to 0. Now, this was a very simple example. You can find Laplace transform tables that list common time domain functions and their corresponding s domain functions. There's also a list of Laplace transform properties that can help you to find the Laplace transform for a much larger group of functions. We'll go over these properties and apply them to harder functions in future videos. We'll also see how the Laplace domain can help you find the output of an LTI system. Thanks for watching this series on signal processing. There's also a lecture notes PDF in the description. You can leave a comment with any feedback or subscribe to stay up to date. See you next time.